Yes, Nintendo lost a lawsuit over the Nintendo Wii and has to pay $10 million in damages. Of course, Nintendo is likely to appeal that decision, and it could be locked up in litigation again for another year or two, but Nintendo could lose the appeal and still have to pay those damages, and maybe pay even more for putting the company that won through the ringer during the appeal process. And this is something I want to talk about, not because I think that this matters too much. The lawsuit that Nintendo lost here was to a company called iLife. And right now they make mostly those kind of Roomba kind of vacuum cleaners that run themselves through your house. And they sued Nintendo over the accelerometer technology in the Wiimote. And they originally were seeking quite a bit more money and then backed off. And were at, you know, the final ruling ended up being $10 million, which is a payout for 36 million units that sold prior to the lawsuit occurring. And I'm not that concerned about this lawsuit. The lawsuit didn't end with like Nintendo giving a cease and desist. They could still make Wiimotes if they want. Their future money on Wiimotes are not being given to the company. It's only on those 36 million units. And, you know, this might actually get held up in appeal. I don't know. But this brings up a interesting conversation with patent trolls and a lawsuit that's currently pending against Nintendo over the Switch Joy-Cons. Because when I talked about the Switch Joy-Con lawsuit, you know, a month or so ago, a lot of people were telling me that I was making much to do about nothing. And that's because patent trolls and these kind of lawsuits happen all the time to major corporations. But this was a reminder, and it was something I tried to make evident in the video, maybe I didn't do a good enough job, that just because these things happen all the time doesn't mean that the company that should win always does. I think the current lawsuit pending against the Nintendo Switch is dumb. I don't think it has much merit. But that lawsuit over the Joy-Cons and Game Vice, a company who made slide-on adapters for tablets for controllers, it's a frustrating lawsuit, but it's one that could lead to something. And this is a reminder of that, because the lawsuit I kept bringing up that Nintendo lost infamously was a lawsuit over the Nintendo WaveBird controller and the wireless technology in that controller. In fact, Nintendo's loss over that caused them to no longer be able to make the controllers. It's a very interesting situation because Game Vice was going after Nintendo Switch for the Joy-Cons, and they wanted damages and a percentage of every single sale of every single Switch to date, and they also wanted to stop Nintendo's production of Nintendo Switches. And it's highly unlikely, it's very rare for a judge to rule to stop production of a product, especially if the competing product that Nintendo supposedly violated a patent of isn't actually out there in the wild to purchase. So a judge likely wouldn't shut the Switch down anyways. But this lawsuit that Nintendo lost over the Wiimote is important because it is that harsh reminder of, yes, Nintendo can lose lawsuits, even if it feels like they shouldn't lose the lawsuit. Like the lawsuit with iLife had nothing to do with gaming at all. It had to do with life-saving technology when people fall. And it's a very interesting thing. And I don't know if iLife was truly patent trolling, or heck, maybe Nintendo really did steal their technology. I don't know. We're not involved in the legal process. We're not inside Nintendo. We don't know. We just assume it's a patent troll. Because the company's still around. They're obviously still making money. They're not like a company that tanked and they're just trying to get, you know, one big payday here. They're definitely, you know, making products still. But yeah, this is just a really interesting outcome, and Nintendo might win on appeals and it might get tossed out anyways. Although Nintendo might be spending over $10 million to appeal the thing. Sometimes it's about the public reception rather than the actual payout, because public reception, you know, Nintendo doesn't want people to think they're stealing technology. And that's an important reputation they want to keep, even though they have lost in the past, like with the WaveBird. So this is just a situation that really brings forth to me My legitimate concern I had about Game Vice's lawsuit against the Nintendo Switch. And for those who don't know what that lawsuit is, essentially Game Vice is suing Nintendo Switch and over the Nintendo Switch Joy-Cons, saying that their mechanisms used to connect and their mechanisms used for controlling games and all that stuff on the Switch violates their patent for a similar kind of device that connects to the side of a tablet for controllers. And, you know, the Wiki Tab is the one a lot of people talked about because that's a product they actually released, but the actual patents for a product they never released. And, you know, we don't know if they have prototypes of it, because having prototypes of it is actually going to help Game Vice, even though it never released at retail. And it's weird because there have been similar products that clip onto the side of phones and tablets in the past that have released that Game Vice has not gotten after, but those devices and products never really sold well, so it might not have been worth Game Vice's time. I don't know. Game Vice is still around today. They're still making some sort of money somewhere, somehow, some way. Some people must really like some of their products, and maybe they do work well. I don't know. But Game Vice's lawsuit against Nintendo seems laughable on the surface, because if you look at what their products is and you look at the patent and then you look at what Nintendo Switch Joy-Cons are, it doesn't seem like they have much to stand on. But again, just because it doesn't seem like you have much to stand on, it didn't seem like iLife had much to stand on, it doesn't mean that you're going to win. And I don't think the Switch, again, is in serious threat of being shut down, but this lawsuit that Nintendo lost is just that reminder. That reminder that, you know what, folks, no matter how ridiculous a lawsuit sounds, no matter how much we hate patent trolls and all that, you know, all that mumbo jumbo, at the end of the day, we don't actually know what the legal outcome is going to be. And yes, there is a chance that Nintendo can lose. Now, what we do know, however, and this is where you can take some peace of mind out of Nintendo losing the Wiimote lawsuit and having to pay $10 million, is that even if, let's assume the worst possible thing happens and Game Vice wins the lawsuit against Nintendo and the judge favors, you know, Game Vice entirely, so Game Vice not only gets a percentage of every single sale of Nintendo Switch, but Nintendo has to stop production of Nintendo Switches, at least until they develop new technology for the Joy-Cons or a new way of doing it. Let's say that worst possible situation happens. Well, you know what happens next. Nintendo appeals. Nintendo wraps this up in court as long as they can. And we never really get a final judgment on this until 5-6 years from now. And by then, Nintendo's already looking towards the Switch 2 and starting to phase out the Nintendo Switch possibly at that point. So, yeah, it's one of those things where even if the worst possible situation happens, it's probably not going to have any effect on the current generation. It could just have a financial impact on Nintendo, where they're going to have to make a big payout. And yes, Nintendo Switches might have to stop production a little early, but Nintendo's going to plan for that. They're going to have the new Nintendo Switch that doesn't violate the patents. They're going to have the Nintendo Switch 2, which doesn't violate the patents. You know, they're going to figure out exactly why they lost and not, you know, have a new way around it that cannot be wrapped up in that lawsuit, or will require a whole brand new lawsuit, which again could get wrapped up in litigation for 6 years. You know, we're talking about a Wiimote lawsuit that got wrapped up in 2017 and the Wii came out in 2006. So Nintendo is going to do everything they can, even if, especially if they think there's a chance they could lose. They're going to wrap it up in litigations and appeals for as long as they can to keep making the products. That's almost one of the benefits of the downfall of the American political system, or the American political system, the American law system, is that you can basically sue over anything, and there's a ton of loopholes. But the benefit of that is that even if it's a legit lawsuit that you could lose, consumers don't necessarily need to be negatively impacted because of the appeals process. So anyways, I just thought it was an interesting thing to bring up that Nintendo lost this lawsuit for the Wiimote, has to pay iLife $10 million, although Nintendo is appealing it, or plans to appeal. I don't know if the appeal motions have been filed yet, but it's just a really interesting thing, and we'll have to see where it goes from here, because I think all of us, you know, we have a tendency to be overly loyal to the companies that we enjoy their products. I enjoy Nintendo products. But if they legit infringed on this Wii patent and legit, you know, somehow infringed on the Game Vice patent, yeah, Nintendo should be held accountable. I think the Game Vice patent is way less viable than the iLife, but I thought the iLife patent was also not that viable, if I'm being honest. So what do I know? I'm not a judge. I'm not a lawyer. I don't know the fine-tuned details of the situation. But, yeah. Just a reminder, we don't know what's going to happen, but we do know that Nintendo is not going to let this affect us as consumers until it's well after the fact, and we're not even having conversations about the original Nintendo Switch, really, by the time we get that wrapped up. Anyways, folks, I am Nathaniel Ruffledance from Nintendo Prime, and if you like this video, you know what to do, and if you dislike this video, hit that dislike button. Subscribe for more, and as always, folks, I will catch you in the next wave. Just a reminder, we're still going to have our Mario plus Rabbids Kingdom Battle first ever video review, by Nintendo Prime on YouTube later this week. I'll have news later on what day that's going to be. I have not started writing the review yet. I had a long weekend, but yeah. Look forward to that. I'm so excited to get our first ever game review out. Anyways, folks, I'll catch you in the next one.